There are many ways you can overclock hardware, like switching jumper settings, soldering or linking points on a ceramic CPU, or with switches on a motherboard. But today we are going to be talking about overclocking in the BIOS. Before we begin, take the side panel off your PC and make sure the fans are working properly. Next, take a desk fan or window fan and set it blowing air into the case. This will keep it cool while we are doing our testing. Now, access the BIOS. Many systems are different, so pay attention to your boot screen. Now we need to create a safety net by adding a shutdown temperature and a warning temperature. Set the shutdown temperature to the last setting and set the warning to the second to the last setting. This will help prevent hardware damage. Next, check to see if your BIOS has a frequency or voltage control. If you do not, we will show you another way in just a bit. As you can see, the CPU clock speed is set to 200. We recommend taking it up by 5, but since we have already overclocked this, we are setting it to 210. Now save, exit, and reboot. The computer was originally at 2.2 GHz. It now reads 2.31 GHz. In Windows, you can see your gigahertz by going to the control panel and accessing the system. Although we recommend you take the CPU clock speed up by 5 each restart, for stability, we are going to show you what this little CPU chip can do. We have successfully added 300 MHz to the speed of the CPU. Some BIOS might have a front-side bus option instead of a frequency and voltage setting. You can set it higher than the factory setting.